All right. Now, some people, when they buy shares from the stock exchange through their brokers, they intend to, some of them, they intend to sell them as soon as prices improve. Kaya lang, meron namang bumibili for long-term investments. Okay? Some people, when they buy shares through the exchange, they buy for short-term investments, but others for long-term. Okay. Ngayon, if you would be investing on a long-term basis, you may want a stock certificate. Okay? So we refer to it as a certificated transaction. Dali naman tandaan, di ba? Pag mayroong certificate, o di certificated. Pag wala, uncertificated. Okay? So wala namang technical about these terms. This may be understood in their ordinary sense. Okay? So when a certificate is issued for an investment, we refer to it as a certificated transaction. But if no certificate is issued for the transaction, we refer to it as uncertificated. Alright, ngayon, yung mga uncertificated transactions, they are safe. Okay? At hindi yan totally paperless. Okay? Alright. If you would look at the law, nakalagay sa law, pag uncertificated, electronic records lang. Kaya lang, hindi yan totally paperless. Alright, to illustrate. Alright, by the way, ha, sabi ko sa inyo, some persons invest on a long, for a long-term purpose and others short-term. Ganito yung short-term. May mga investors, wala na magawa. Ito yung mga wala na magawa sa buhay. Pagdating ng 9:30 in the morning ng business day, nakatutok na yan doon sa television channel o kaya doon sa radio station. Pinakikinggan niya yung movement ng prices of shares of certain corporations. Right? These persons had already developed a familiarity with the price of shares of certain corporations and their movement. Okay? Ito yung mga tao na sabihin sa mga asawa nila, o sige, titignan ko kung makakapag-raise ako ng pamalengke mo bukas. Okay? Kasi ginagawa nila, pag 9:30, di ba? 9:30, tinanong niya, nabalit na, dinig niya, ang presyo ng San Miguel, San Miguel shares 57 per share. Alright. Kung familiar ka na sa movement ng prices ng San Miguel, sabi mo, uy, mababa yun. So, anong gagawin mo? If you are that person, sabi mo, tawagan mo yung broker mo, ibili mo ako. So many shares. Okay? Alright. After a few seconds, after a few minutes, sabi ng broker niya, sir, naibili ko na kayo. Done. Okay? O, ngayon. Babantayin yan hanggang mag-aalas 12 na. Okay? Ngayon, halimbawa, 11:30 or 11:45, nabalitaan niya na hindi na 57, kundi na 60 na. Then he calls up again his broker. Sabi niya, oh, yung binili ko kanina, ibenta mo na. So, in short, meron na siyang profit na 3 pesos per share. Okay? May mga ganun. They just keep track of the movement of the price of shares from 9:30 up to 12 noon. Okay? Ngayon, binili mo ng 9:30 or 9:35, ibinenta mo ng 11:30, may certificate ka ba noon? Wala. Hindi mo magagawa agad yung certificate. If you want a certificate, don't expect a certificate right away. There is a processing period and it's about 3 months. Ganun katagal. Why? Kasi, ibabayad pa ng taxi sa BIR yan. Tapos, clearance. Eh, alam nyo naman gano'ng kabilis ang BIR, di ba? O, ayun. Kaya, gano'ng kabilis, ma-issue yung certificate. Okay? So, don't expect that pag binayaran mo, kuha mo yung certificate. No. Okay? So, if your purpose is to sell what you had bought, as soon as the prices had gone up, you tell your salesman, huwag mo na ako ibigay ng certificate. Ngayon, you might ask, bakit naman ganon? If his intention is to sell when the price shall have gone up, kasi ganito naman ang problema. If you were issued a certificate, kaya nabawa, 3 months later, you were issued a certificate, okay, and you decided to sell because you heard that the price had gone up, you cannot sell right away. Because the present practice in the stock exchange is, kung meron kang stock certificate, you surrender that first to your broker. And the broker will first validate the genuineness of your certificate. And the validation period, 5 working days. Alright? Only after validation could you sell. Eh kung mag-aantay ka ng 5 working days, in the meantime, prices could have gone down. O, hindi mo na bibenta. Okay? So, yun naman ang disadvantage ng certificated. If the owner of the shares had decided to sell, he cannot sell right away because of the validation process which takes 5 days to complete. 5 working days yan. Okay. Now, you may ask, bakit? Bakit kinakailangan pa ng validation na yan? The stock exchange had a bad experience where there was a sale of shares which, unfortunately, were covered by counterfeit stock certificates. Kaya nagkagulo. Why? Eh, yung broker selling the shares, hindi naman niya alam na fake pala yung stock certificates ng kliyente niya. Eh, anong naibenta dun sa seller, dun sa buyer? Wala. Kasi fake yun. So in short, big legal problem. So after that problem had arisen, nagkaroon ng rules sa stock exchange. If the shares are covered by a stock certificate, no outright sale, okay? The certificate shall have to be submitted by the client to the broker, and the broker will let it through the validation process. Only after the certificate shall have been validated could there be a sale of the shares covered by it. Okay? So, kaya kung ikaw ang intention mo to sell as soon as the price shall have gone up, you tell your broker or you tell your salesman, huwag mo na akong bigyan ng certificate dyan. Nothing to worry. Maraming records yan. Unang-una, if you bought, di ba sabi ko sa inyo kanina, bibigyan ka ng purchase confirmation by your broker. So, yung purchase confirmation na yon, that's already your proof of ownership of the shares. Kaya kahit wala kang certificate, you feel secure. Alright? Ngayon, now you might say, paano naman kung magdidiklara ng dividendo? Walang problema. Because the corporation that issued the shares will have a record that you already own those shares as of a particular period. Kaya yung mga dividendo, sa iyo rin pupunta. Okay? And as I said earlier, the transaction is not totally paperless. Yung nga, may purchase confirmation at kahit mawala mo yung purchase confirmation, secured ka pa rin. Why? Merong 3 electronic records of your transaction. Remember, as defined in the code, when you talk about uncertificated, these are transactions which only have electronic records. So, ano ba yung mga electronic records na yan? Alright, ganito ha? Yung salesman mo is like an account executive. Right? meron niyang laptop. So, all your transactions through him, naka-laptop niya yan. So, doon sa kanyang laptop, andoon na may record na. But not only his computer, the computer of the broker whom he represents also has a computer record of your purchase. Hindi lang yun. Pati yung sa stock exchange, may computer record. So, lahat yan, sipin mo, 3 electronic records of your stock ownership. So, nothing to worry. Got it?